The first one we're going to take a look at premiered during the Oscars last night. I didn't watch the Oscars, so I didn't see it then. So there's that. But I had heard of this movie. I didn't even realize it was so close to being done. And that's going to be West Side Story by Steven Spielberg. And while I enjoy the original West Side Story from back in the day, for what it is, it's a spectacle. I mean, as far as musicals go, I like a musical as much as the next guy. I like original musicals, which West Side Story is. I enjoy it, and I think, okay, I could see an update happening and it being, you know, viable and a good thing. I really, when I heard, oh, they're remaking West Side Story, I was like, oh, okay, well, that's sure, fine, no problem. But the thing that actually got me kind of more hyped than anything, that made me kind of perk my ears up and say, oh, okay, yeah, I'll definitely check that out, would be that it's being directed by Steven Spielberg. Steven Spielberg is, you know, America's storyteller. He's a great director. He's made some of the best movies ever. He's a wonderful director. And so that did make me take a bit more notice here. Now, this is a official teaser trailer, but it's a minute and a half long teaser trailer, so I'm assuming it's not going to be like a, you know, a 30-second TV spot. We're actually going to get to see something, maybe hear some of the songs. I assume the songs are going to be pretty much what they were in the original. So anyway, let's jump right into this bad boy. So here is the new trailer for West Side Story. Okay, they got that whistle from the original. Are they come in and do their clicking, their snapping? I wonder if it, does this take place nowadays? I like the look. Looks good. Oh yeah, this is not nowadays. Are they the Jets and the Sharks? Oh, I like that. That's neat. I'm gonna bust out the song. Do it. Hey, it's Baby Driver. If nothing else, being Steven Spielberg, you know it's gonna be a spectacle and have plenty of money behind it to make it look right. I don't recognize anybody else offhand. Okay. All right. December. All right. Well, yeah. West Side Story coming in December from Steven Spielberg. I mean, that really didn't. Nothing against it. I mean, it was a teaser trailer. That's what a. What else can you expect from it? It showed us what the movie's going to look like, and I mean, that's all you can really expect from a teaser trailer. The music, we didn't really get any of the actual music. I know it had that one in the background, but we didn't get like to see what the, you know, how it's going to play out on film. There were a few parts I saw him singing, but it didn't actually have any audio. But I mean, I'm sure it's going to be the same songs. Steven Spielberg seems like the type who's not going to change that formula too much. He's just going to more or less update the visuals and maybe the how epic it is. The grand scale, which the original was pretty grand, but of course we have the technology and the means to make it even bigger now. And Steven Spielberg just seems like the type, he's not going to mess with something like that too much. He's going to stick to the basic plan of the original West Side Story. So I think that if you're a fan of West Side Story, the original one, you're probably in good hands here. Depended on the only thing that would really be a determining factor would be the performances, the voice performances, the singing. Which, I mean, I don't think Steven Spielberg's just going to let him have like shit voice or singing performances. I wouldn't think so. Not in a musical, but Steven Spielberg is one of those directors, which he's made some blockbusters, some of the great movies out there that you do get excited for. But his more recent stuff is recent, meaning the past like 15 years. A lot of it has been things that like I hear about and I'm like, yeah, I'm sure it'll be okay. It'll be fine. I mean, it's Steven Spielberg, so I'll see it. And yeah, I'm not really hyped about seeing it. But then when I do see it, it's like, holy shit, that was so fucking good. And that's probably what this is going to be. And if it wrangles more people into, you know, West Side Story that maybe aren't as willing to jump into that. I think it was made in the 50s. I think it was the late 50s. It may have been the early 60s. I can't remember. But, you know, some people are not as willing as to look at older film as newer. So if it gets some people into that, then good on it. I don't think this is going to be bad. Worst case scenario, I would say this is pretty much going to be more or less a prettier carbon copy of the original. And if it is, there will be people that inevitably give it shit and say, oh, what was the point? It's just the same thing over again. Well, I think the point is to just update it, make it look and sound prettier. And that's fine with something like this. That's all this movie needs. It doesn't need to be retold in any grand way. They just need to tell the same story, stick to that template, and, you know, maybe do a couple of little different things here or there, but just, you know, amp it up, like, visually. That's really all it needs, is to be amped up visually, which the original, for its time, looked great. So I think that they could, I hope that they don't do a bunch of CGI and stuff. I hope it, the original had some really striking imagery, and it was all done on sets, but they were real big, grand sets. It was a grand movie, and I hope that he retains that feel. I hope it retains that kind of just larger-than-life feel that the original had. If they can do that, I think this movie could be successful. I think it's old enough and far enough away and out of the, you know, the popular zeitgeist enough to where people aren't as familiar with it. I think people are more familiar with the name West Side Story than the songs and the film itself, especially younger people. And so, yeah, this could actually open up some doors for some people in some older cinema, and I think that's a good thing. It's more or less Romeo and Juliet, by the way, just musical updated at the time form, not updated now, but so yeah, that's more or less the story right there. So yeah, West Side Story, I liked what I saw. I will definitely see it just because Steven Spielberg's involved, but I mean, if it's shit, I'll call him on it too. But Steven Spielberg's track record has shown that he is much more dependable than not. I mean, the vast majority of the time, you can almost always depend that he's going to put out a good film. He's had some, I mean, he's made a lot of movies, but he's had a couple that weren't as good, or a couple that were just straight up bad. But for the vast majority of the time, his movies are entertaining and they're fun to watch. And I'm sure this one will be too.
Thanks for checking out this clip from the Jarcast Movie Podcast. If you like this and want more, then check out the Jacob Anders Review YouTube channel, where you can also find movie reviews every Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and Sunday. You can also listen to the entire podcast on all major podcasting platforms such as Spotify, Google, and iTunes. So if you prefer audio, whichever one is your preferred, check it out there. Once again, I really appreciate it, and thanks for watching. And as always, stay sexy, YouTube.